We're really looking at Gen AI as not a moment in time, but a long journey. We think of it quite a lot about, you know, when we first started using computers, and we think that AI is going to be just as transformational. We look back and try and borrow from some of those lessons. It took quite a while for everyone to figure out how to really use computers to their full value. So what we're really looking for is ways that we can accelerate that journey and adopt AI in a way that can help our work sooner. What we pay attention to is the expectations of our citizens are constantly increasing, and that has a lot to do with technology. They can shop anytime, they can get things delivered to their door, they go to websites that know exactly what they're looking for. And while it might not be government that drove those expectations, they're in our residents and they're in our citizens, and we need to respond to them, and we need to try and reshape our services to meet those expectations. So innovation to me means we've got to find new ways to do the work that we're doing that is more responsive to what our residents expect. I think it's easy to feel rushed. I think it's easy to feel like we need to integrate AI into everything we do, but we're really taking the long view. This is a technological evolution. It's not just a new product or a new service. This is a new way to approach our work. So we're really trying to take the longer view approach to how can we fundamentally shift our work, not just introduce new things. I think it's easy to think that AI is creating new challenges for data privacy and data protection, but what I think it's doing more is just revealing the challenges that were already there. We're trying to think of this as an opportunity presented by AI to take a look at, are we doing all the right and responsible things to protect personal information and private data, and make sure we've got everything in place to treat that those things responsibly. The biggest impact AI is having on our employees so far is just that, what they call the tyranny of the blank page. It's getting those words on the page and then allowing them to spend their time really applying their expertise and refining those messages. So it's nice that AI gets the paragraphs and the sentences built that they can really then apply their expertise to and refine the messages to bring it to a new level. We're a smaller municipality. It's a big transformational journey like AI is something that in a lot of ways larger organizations can be more prepared for. Microsoft's been invaluable at sort of helping us understand as a smaller organization how we can benefit from these really transformational technologies as well, and make us realize that you don't have to be a city of a million people with 5,000 employees to really take advantage of it. They present it in this small, scalable way that allows us to embark on opportunities that are the right size for our organization. I think the biggest impact coming is our ability to turn generative AI into something that just provides information to our residents, to something that can take action on their behalf. So we're looking for ways to have it not just answer questions about our services, but to actually connect our residents with those services. AI is new for everybody, and even the partners we've been engaged with are amazed at how quickly things are changing. So for us, it's about being patient while we're being proactive, and it's about, you know, putting together solutions, but knowing that those solutions are going to continue to change over the coming years. So embracing the fact that we're on an exciting journey, but it's a learning journey as well.